Hello. Today, I'll explain a new approach to the animation in PSE. To begin with, let's make this butterfly flap its wings. Right now, the wings are stretched out. To imitate the upstroke, I duplicate the butterfly layer and transform the wings like this. The idea is to show these two layers alternately. So I open Animation Dialog. The first frame is already there. I only have to hide the upper layer. The document view doesn't update. That's exactly why we need this preview. Now I duplicate the first frame, and here is the second one. For the frame 2, I hide the lower layer and show the upper one. By the way, we also can toggle the layer visibility with a mere double click. By default, the new animation is set to play once. I set looping to forever and open the image with my default web browser. Well, the animation works. However, I'd probably like to slow it down. I return to PSE Editor and set the current frame's delay to 0.2 seconds. Then I double-click the frame 1 and set its delay to 0.3 seconds. Now I hold down Shift key, add the frame 2 to the selection, and hide the background layer from both frames. Let's preview the result. I think the speed is okay, but the graphics quality is rather poor. So I run GIF Options command, increase the number of colors, add white matte to eliminate the jagged edges, and click Done. I preview the result. Well, it's about okay. So I run Export as GIF command, save the animation, and close the dialog. Let's consider another example. I drag this B onto the summertime document. Now let's make it fly across the image. I rename the new layer, scale it down, and move it to the initial location. Then I open the animation dialog, create a new frame, close the dialog, move the B to the end location. Reopen the animation dialog, add the first frame to the selection, run tween command, and insert 20 intermediate frames. The layer position for each new frame has been set automatically. I set looping to forever, open GIF options. To reduce this banding, I increase the number of colors and the dithering amount. Done. Let's preview the result and return to PSE. Now pay your attention to this option. It means that any changes to the layer visibility or position for the first frame will also affect all other frames. I'll explain. I select the frame 1, close the dialog, and move the B up. Now I open the animation window and preview the result. As you can see, the entire trajectory went up, so I probably need to change the direction starting from this point. First, I have to decide on where the change begins. Let it be the frame 9. Then I go to the last frame, close the dialog, move the layer down, open the dialog, hold down Shift key, select the frames I want to modify, make sure that B layer is selected, and run Interpolate Layer command. Done. I open the animation in the browser. Well, it seems to work. Now let's add into this animation one more object. I select the first frame, it's important. Click OK. Go to the Butterfly document, select both butterfly layers, and drag them onto the summertime image. I link the added layers to each other, scale them down, turn the layers, and move them to the initial location. Then I open the animation dialog, select the last frame, duplicate the frame, click OK. Move the layers to the end location, open the dialog, add the previous frame to the selection, run the tween command, and insert 30 frames. Currently, in all the new frames, the wings are stretched out. To make them flap, I select the odd frames. I hide the layer butterfly and show the butterfly copy. I preview the animation. Well, it's almost fine now, but I find it a bit too busy. So I double-click the first frame and increase its delay time. Finally, I export the animation as a GIF file. Finished.